Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Uswi nafsi wa iyakum bitakwa Allahi subhanahu wa ta'ala wa tiba'il Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our dear esteemed viewers on Thuraya Islam Media and our social platforms, bi'idhnillah. Praise be to Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. We are indeed at most thankful to Allah for the gift of life and there's so many benefits. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban, to bless us in the months of Rajab and Sha'ban, but most importantly, wa balighna Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to deliver us and enable us be in the month of Ramadan and fast the month of Ramadan. Brothers and sisters in the fold of Islam, Ramadan is a fruitful season. It is a season of beneficial reaping. But alhamdulillah, that ahamiyatu shahr Ramadan, some of the key points, the key values that we benefit from fasting the holy month of Ramadan. And that is the topic that we are going to address shortly and briefly, but with an optimum importance of follow-up, inshallah. Brothers and sisters in the fold of Islam, one of the very first Islamic virtues, before we talk about the scientific benefits that we shall later on look at, the social, the economic, and so many others, the Islamic diniya, ahamiyatul shahr Ramadan, the key points, bi'idhnillah, fawaid, the key values and benefits, shahr Ramadan, of the month of Ramadan, in the Islamic perspective. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that la'allakum tattaqun. The verse is long, but in one of its quotes, that la'allakum tattaqun, it is basically to gain piety. While we are in the month of Ramadan, bi'idhnillah, we abstain from so many unacceptable acts. And that is one of the key virtues that leads us towards taqwa. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. Verily, the best person amongst you is one who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most. So in doing whatever we do in the month of Ramadan, since sufidat shayateen, that the shaitans are limited in terms of involvement in our affairs, it is a basic aspect to extend our taqwa. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that ataqwa hahuna, verily piety is found within the inner part of someone's heart, bi'idhnillah. This is one of the virtues of Ramadan, that we are expected to end up with taqwa. La'allakum tattaqun, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states it. Where do we get this taqwa from? There's so much participation in Islamic acts definitely leads someone and delivers them to taqwa, bi'idhnillah. While you are in Ramadan, you abstain, though even it's haram, but you do not lie. La'allakum tattaqun. It's a factor that leads you to doing good. Why? Wa innal birra yahdi ila al-jannah. Doing good leads you to Jannah. But taqwa, you don't lie. La'allakum tattaqun. So that you become pious. You pray. La'allakum tattaqun, so that you get pious, bi'idhnillah. You fast, la'allakum tattaqun, bi'idhnillah. It is acceptable. We cleanse our souls by the virtue of the so many acts that we participate in, la'allakum tattaqun. And that is one of the very first virtues of the month of Ramadan, bi'idhnillah. Second, al-ijtinab. It is involving distancing from hawa nafs. Allah says in the Holy Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ Whosoever will fear, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ Whosoever will fear involvement and indulging in despicable acts, bi'idhnillah, to stand in front of Allah to defend them, وَنَاهَا النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى And you prevent your soul from desires, bi'idhnillah. While we are in the month of Ramadan, we are in such a situation that even when we want to do some things, hawa nafs, they go away. We can't do them. We try to distance ourselves. A person who is fasting cannot abuse. A person who is fasting, it is unacceptable for that person to commit adultery, to slap one another, to do slandering. These are things that our hearts always feel inclined to. Hawa nafs. It is one way through the month of Ramadan, bi'idhnillah. Allah talks about the soul and he says that inna nafsa la ammaratum bi stable things, but over our desires of the soul, bi'idhnillah. It's a virtuous season. Therefore, prepare for it aptly. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nafs. One of the other virtues, bi'idhnillah, is al-idhhar wahdatul islamiyya. It is a display of the unity of Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant whosoever comes out to do good bi-idhnillah, to unite the Muslims, especially in such a season. Unity and uniformity of the Muslims is one of the key benefits. Up for more than an hour, they stand up for more than an hour. People could stand in their homes, but bi-idhnillah man qama Ramadan, it is something that we do within the masajid in groups bi-idhnillah. Why? Wahdatul Islamiyya, the unity and the uniformity of Islam. It comes out specifically in the month of Ramadan and in other months, but most especially in the month of Ramadan. When we are breaking our fast as families, unity bi-idhnillah, while we are doing whatever we are doing, when you look at Salatul Jummah in the month of Ramadan, it's so much outstanding and distinct. Unity of Islam. The month of Ramadan brings us together. All Muslims are uniform in act. No one fasts for only 4 hours because they are so rich. No one fasts for 28 hours because they are so healthy. Unity of Islam and uniformity is one of the key things that are displayed in the month of Ramadan. We do the same acts. We break our fast at the same time. We participate in congregational activities in the month of Ramadan. And that is the third virtue and the third aspect. Diniya, ahamiyatu, fawaid. Ash-shahru ar-Ramadan al-Karim. Some of the key Islamic benefits and virtues of the month of Ramadan. We have talked about piety as the first. We have talked about Islamic brotherhood, unity and uniformity as another virtue. We have also talked about our nafs controlling our desires. Finally, the fourth aspect, bi-idhnillah, for our series that we shall look at as one of the key importances of the month of Ramadan, bi-idhnillah, is Al-Ghufran min Rabbina, is being forgiven in the month of Ramadan. Shaharu Tawbah, it is a month of forgiveness bi-idhnillah. Tawbah alone is a great concept that we can go on breaking down. But there isn't any month where Allah's mercy, whereby Allah's forgiveness is very closer to a person like the month of Ramadan. Shaharu Tawbah. That is why we say, Allahumma innaka afuwun. It is oftenly said that Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what are the best words to say in the month of Ramadan? The Prophet could talk about words that ask for rizq, words that ask Allah to give us hijjah, words that ask Allah to do this. But he said that qul Allahumma innaka afuwun karimun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. All these words are broken down by the scholars and they direct to forgiveness. Shaharu Tawbah, a month of forgiveness. And that is a key Islamic benefit, bi-idhnillah. In so many ahadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam talked about al-itq min al-nar, whereby people are saved from the hellfire because Allah has forgiven them in the month of Ramadan. Why? Fasting the holy month of Ramadan, it is a reason to expiate your past sins, bi-idhnillah. Yufarlahu ma mabwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives that person. He is forgiven out of the sins that he committed in the past. So, as we extend towards the month of Ramadan, there are some key benefits that we shall wait for. Whenever you do anything in the world, bi-idhnillah, you are subjected to the courts of jurisprudence. You are being scrutinized. You are being asked why you do this. People put you on the wall. You might end up in prison. Others might forgive you. Others might not forgive you. They are willing to get back. But the aspect of forgiveness in front of Allah does not only stop on erasing your sins, but also admission into Jannah. Muslims, while we fast the month of Ramadan, one of the key benefits we should not miss out is being forgiven, bi-idhnillah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that rukma'an fi mri'in, let that person suffer a disease. It's a disease that involves leprosy, but it also goes further into a distancing, but also a very intricate disease. He talked about it during the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's time. It should affect the nose of a person. Why? The person who fasts the month of Ramadan and he leaves the month of Ramadan without being forgiven in such a month of forgiveness. Shaharu Tawbah, tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha, seek for Allah's forgiveness. It's a month of repentance. That is one of the key virtues that we should be awaiting for the month of Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us reach the month of Ramadan so that we gain the four virtues we have talked about today. One of them is at-taqwa, la'allakum tattaqun, so that you gain piety. The second one, bi-idhnillah, بإذن الله توقع الهوى نفسي ونهى النفس عن الهوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى. When you desist from the desires of the souls, فإن الجنة هي المأوى. Definitely your abode will be Jannah. In the month of Ramadan, the third aspect is unity and uniformity of Islam, بإذن الله. Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. As we await the month of Ramadan, we are going to fast the same way. People in Canada, people in Uganda, people in Ethiopia, our viewers of Thuraya Islam Media Channel, wherever you might be, unity and uniformity is one of the key disciplines we get in the month of Ramadan. The fourth virtue we have talked about tonight, bi'idhnillah, is repentance and forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We dearly ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to privilege us with those four facts, bi'idhnillah, and we end up as victors at the end of this season. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Thank you for watching us on Thuraya Islam Media. We kindly ask you to continue subscribing to our different channels. But as we unpackage the different calls of sustaining the work of Dawah, please keep on, inshallah, when we give you, when we call upon you, bi'idhnillah, to contribute in any way. We have an upcoming project, especially about Thuraya Islam Media Studio, inshallah. The different sheikhs have talked about it, sheikh charitably and actively. Our number is very, very clear. 0705-111-999, bi'idhnillah. I repeat finally, 0705-111-999. The number is registered in the names of Thuraya Islam Media, inshallah. For any aid you might give in terms of space, for any aid you might give in terms of moral guidance, for any aid you might give in terms of monetary facilitation, for any aid you might give in terms of equipment, we shall welcome it, because what you are viewing right now can be better and it can spread further and wider in case we have your support, in case we partner with you, inshallah. May Allah reward you and us as well abundantly. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. يقول جلاله وابتغي فيما اتاك الله الدار الاخره baganda bange munna bandaba matendo ga Allah jalla jalaluhu acha tukumye tumusaba Allah sebengero kusira ku nabi Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam aya jinkurembeza elimu echo kuiga chamanyi ekutegeza timwe byengera byolina sibibyo bya Allah byabikuwa si magezi manji banji abakusinga magezi banji abakusinga amanyi ne Allah gugu yasimu kuwebyo byakuwadde kati Allah gambye nti wabtaghi fima ataka Allahu daral akhira ebyo Allah byakuwa tetenkanye okulaba nga naye kale kono osinziirira kubagenda bikubuuza hadithi eraga nti omuntu agenda kuva mu bbaliro okutuusa nga abuuzibwa ebintu bino ekimu ku byo ogenda kubuuzibwa ku mali Allah gyakuwadde ku sente Allah zakuwadde eziri ku akawunti zolina zeziri